Okay, now that you know how to get the song started and get moving on it, now we're going to go ahead and go into the real meat of this, what you really want to do anyway, and that's the intro or the middle riff to the song. Now, I've got it broken down, as I shared with you before, into six parts. This is part one, and it's the first 12 notes to the riff. I'm going to show you how to play them, and then right after I show you on the guitar, it's going to go into the tabs on screen, and I'll talk you through it at a much slower pace and show you how to play this thing, okay? I think you're going to enjoy this. All right, here we go. This is the first 12 notes of the riff. It goes like this. And there you have it. Now let's take a look on screen. Let's look at the tabs. Okay, you're seeing the tabs there. It says part one, and that first row of numbers 1 through 12 in green, those are actually the column numbers that I'm going to use, and I'm only putting those on there so that I can communicate to you quickly. If I say column 4, your eyes will go right over to that that row, and we'll know, or that column, we'll know what I'm talking about. Okay, of course, on these tabs, that little E is their high string, your high sixth string. B is 2, G3, D4, A4. 5 and E is 6. Okay, look at column 1 where you see that 1/3. That slash is my nomenclature for a slide. That means that you're sliding from the first fret up to the third fret. Now, I want you to know that is not, you don't hit that string twice. That is one note and all you're doing is sliding on it. Okay, just one slide, one pick. That's why it's in one column. Okay, now look at B, and you've got a 1 to 3 on the second string as well. But since they're put together right under each other, you play them simultaneously. Whoops, now look at there. We've also got a G with a 2-4 slide. That means on the second fret up to the fourth fret, right? And since they're all underneath each other in the same column, we do it together, so that slide sounds like this. And again, that is one note. So column 1 is played like that. Column 2, 3, 4, and 5 is just the second and first string. And all we're doing there is hitting those on the third fret. 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, now look at column number 6. You're just hitting that first and second string. But look at that in green. I highlighted that for you to make it a little clearer. In column 7, you've got an H5. All that's telling you, that H indicates it's a hammer-on, okay? And a hammer-on is simply just, you don't pick it. You just go from 3, you're just going to hammer on to that 5th fret. Like that, okay? So let's play the first 7 notes. It'd be like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's that hammer. Okay, 8, 9, 10 is just like the previous 4, 3, 4, and 5. Hit it 3 times. So let's play the first 10 notes now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, now 11 is you're sliding down from the 3 down to the 1 and the 4 down to a 2. And then, you know, look at number 12 where it has a P0. P means pull off. And all you're doing is you're pulling your, taking your fingers right off of the string. Now, you can play that either way. Sometimes I pick that 0-0, the open second and open third. And sometimes I just do a pull off. So I put the pull off on there for you, but you just understand you can do it either way. So let's play those first 12 notes, okay? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. One more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now I'm going to do it at regular pace for you. All right, now you can practice that. And let's go on to part two. Hey, you're going to love this. Part two has 15 notes. All right, let's take a look at those on-screen tabs.